During the winter of 2018, railroads including Norfolk Southern were on a steep deadline to upgrade signals to be PTC compliant. According to the FRA, PTC, or Positive Train Control's purpose, is to prevent train-on-train collisions, fatalities in M&W work zones, and derailments caused by fouled switches. It's March 11, 2018, and I'm trackside along Norfolk Southern's Reading to Allentown mainline. Today we'll be witnessing a full day's work by the folks at Railroad Controls as they remove signals at CP Blandon on the Reading line. Railroad Controls were contracted out along with a few other companies to assist in the signal cutovers across Norfolk Southern's system throughout 2018. Before we get to the signals, first there's a few trains that get through prior to the line being out of service. First up is train 19G. Today's 19G is led by a pair of GE locomotives lugging a lengthy train on their way to Conway, Pennsylvania. Once the rear of 19G passed, we got a brief second to speak to one of the railroad control crew members, Skyler, who was in the middle of explaining that they had a few more trains to send through before they removed the old signals.
What are you doing with the old ones?
It's all up to the big bosses.
Oh, okay. Huh. So you guys aren't taking them out?
Right. We will be, but we won't take them with us. Oh. Yeah, I think, I don't know what they may lay them over there, but I don't know if we're bringing them back to their yard. Or, the only reason we can't do it is because we have to wait on the trains to not come for us to be that close to the track with all that equipment.
Yeah, right. Yeah, no doubt.
So we're just waiting now.
With some time before the next train, the railroad controls crew gets their equipment ready and starts staging it before they remove any signals. Our next train, Norfolk Southern Hotshot Intermodal Train 212, roars past the Conrail-style G-Type, which is displaying a diverging clear from one of the final times. To work between trains, the railroad control crew starts loosening the bolts holding the signal to the base. A mere 10 minutes later, and the final train through the work zone makes an appearance. Interchanged in Chicago from the BNSF in Los Angeles, Norfolk Southern Train 20K hustles eastbound by the G-Type signal at Blandon for the final time. With 20K's hind end in the clear, a curfew goes into effect, stopping all train traffic until all work is completed by the folks at Railroad Controls, who get to work immediately, starting with checking wiring and relays, and then moving on to removing the iconic G-type signals.
I didn't want to miss it. We came down yesterday, but I didn't want to miss any shot.
That's all true.
Get that 1700 at the yard?
I have no idea.
I
Dustin, get it all the Wait, don't start the fishing. Wait.
Thank you.
old signals removed and the new replacements operational at CP Blandon. The railroad controls gang heads to their drop location in Lyons to pick up two intermediate signals which they would place in service. In this case, the signals from Blandon were in a dilapidated state after being thrown in the dumpster, but upon going through the proper channels, I was able to save a piece of history. 8 hours after our day began with 19G, with the setting sun providing some ambience, Norfolk Southern Allentown, Pennsylvania to Camden, New Jersey Manifest Train 38G breaks the silence on their short journey west before turning east in Reading. After 38G came the first eastbound after the curfew, but my last train of the day, the Norfolk Southern Autorack train 18, as they knocked down the diverging clear on their journey to Dormouse Auto Terminal in New Jersey. I hope you all enjoyed. This was the day the signals fell at CP Blandon.